layers of pigment and paint in this area. Wet on dry, wet on wet, and a couple layers. And what I want to do is add some cracks. So I have this small flat brush. And I'm just going to layer it with some clean water. And I'm just going to add some cracks by actually rubbing it back and forth and rubbing away some of the pigment. Instead of going in with a white gouache or something like that. And so you can see here, and I'm going to clean it up. Maybe I'll zoom in. So I'm going to So you can see some of these little guys here, so I'll do another one here. Just some cracks. And all I'm doing is just a clean water. Take my paper towel and run through it. So you can see there's just some small textural elements. And the areas where I have more pigment, the better this effect will be. But with watercolor, it's sometimes the smallest touches. So see there, I just kind of scraped and carved away some of that pigment. Hey John, how's it going? How's your weekend been? Yeah, right now you guys are staring at texture to this, so I'm gonna follow some of these edges that have been randomly created and just fade those out. Thanks, man. Painted a window. How do you paint a window? You paint on a window, or you painted a window? Okay. So, clean water again. Try to get some lines in here. Get some nice layers on things. Let me can even get some highlights into this bloody area. And this is just another way to create, right? So I have this solid area right here. This is another way to create like levels and layers and kind of get back to areas where you're at. And you're never gonna get back to pure white, but you don't have to. Right? So here, where there was a nice full solid red color, I'm now, you know, by rubbing lightly or rubbing for a while or whatever else, created some depth and texture in there. So I'll do the same there. Get some more clean water. Oh, nice. So it's sort of a pseudo stained glass then, I guess, huh? So I'm gonna cut into some of this blood, create some lines for motion and texture. Let's add some more cracks over here. What you end up painting on the glass? All right, so clean water. See if I can create some more organic kind of flows here with blood. There's blood, and just kind of. Alright. And I usually have a clean cloth, and it'll just help me dab through. And it'll help pick up some of that loose pigment that I've loosened up with this brush. This is really almost mindless stuff. You're just kind of picking a few areas, seeing what you can rub away. You can actually render with this. It just takes a long time. But I like it because it just... allows me to just really create textures that are a little bit different. So I've lightened this area here. And I'm going to come back with some pigment and paint along the edges to really pull that out, right? I'm just gonna go back and play with this dark and light kind of pattern. I now know what kind of music you like, Warshi. I'm gonna add some little wash of red here for the blood that's dripping. Let's add some red into this arrow, especially the tip. Make it look a little bloody. Sounds like fun. Hope you guys are having fun watching me paint this boot. Or actually paint the ground around this boot. And so I have these scratches now. And what I'm going to do is put some shadow on the top part of it. Right. I'm pretty dry. This will help accentuate some of these cracks, right? Every crack has, there's a shadow and a light part to a crack. It's not just white. Darker Payne's, darker black, maybe like a Payne's gray, which is awesome. How's that look? Add a few more cracks here, or blood, or something. Let's add some blood here, and some blood here. Add blood everywhere. I'm liking all these little random patterns I'm able to pull out here. My eyes right now are just kind of looking at all the shapes that have happened from literally from earlier before, where I just like dumped a big wash and just let the colors play. This is one of those fun parts in watercolor where you just have no idea. But I'm pulling in some of these shapes. back out. While I work on this bottom part. Well, parts of it go with the flow. Parts of it are very well, like, penciled out and figured out and painted in here. Some of this area was go with the flow and stuff, but overall, you gotta have some plans for some parts, and then some of it is just go with it. So I'm trying to, my thought process right now is trying to add more red to the boundary between the ninjas and the ground, on the ground, so that there is a higher contrast. So again, to pull out the ninjas and to make sure they pop a little bit more from the ground, I am going to paint the ground. And later on I'll go in with some, maybe a very thin line of like lamp black or something to outline. Let's kind of outline the bottom here, right? Yay! Glad your stuff turned out okay, Isna and Dragors and Orshi. Thanks, man. Thanks, John. I try to stay loose. Watercolor, you can't try to be too tight. Or if you do, you have to be tight from the very, very beginning. I'm glad it turned out okay, Isnai. I'm glad it turned out okay. Alright, let's see if I can scrape some of this away here. I want it to look like this ninja was scraping on the ground. Speaking of scraping, maybe I'll put like three rows of claw marks on the ground. That could be cool. Get this. There we go. So just blocking out and creating contrast in the areas that I really want to be separated. So I'm following this all the way across from left to right, kind of make my way through. Takes practice. I'll try to help you wherever I can. If you have any questions, this night, feel free to ask. I remember going through the same issues when I picked up a watercolor. It's only been a couple of years for me. But I remember the first 6 months of picking up watercolor. I swear to you, I threw away so much artwork. I had no idea what I was doing. None. When I first started, I decided to be very diligent about it, and so at the time I was still working full-time jobs and stuff like that. I would wake up at around 4:30 or 5 o'clock every morning. I would paint for about 3 hours until about 8:30, and then I would leave for work. And so I would get three hours in the morning, and then I would come back and paint for another 2 to 3 hours in the evening after work. So I'd do the creative stuff in the morning because that's when my mind was most energetic, and at the end of the day when I was kind of tired, or you know, my mind's a little exhausted, I do stuff like this where, you know, I don't have all the thinking has already been done. And I'll just try to add on, you know, this is sort of slightly mindless. You're looking for patterns, you're not really going with little instinct stuff here. So I would get about 5 hours of painting in Monday through Friday. So maybe 4 days. And then at least one good day on a weekend. So I was probably getting anywhere around 25 hours a week for about a year. Yeah, well, I think the other thing that is important for watercoloring, if you're going to pick it up, is not to forget your... Before watercolors, I was drawing, you know, I had many, many, many years of drawing and just kind of getting... figures, anatomy, proportions, layout. I was doing a lot of that stuff too. So when it came to watercolors, I was already comfortable with, I wasn't also trying to watercolor and figure out anatomy. I wasn't trying to watercolor and figure out how to draw a hand or paint a hand. I already had some of that basic knowledge. So I think if you get into painting, it's important not to forget all the other tools that you have when it comes to traditional drawing and just doing drawing classes and stuff like that. It's important. Drawing will help your painting. I mean, that's why I think that a lot of people, when they pick up watercolor or even other forms of painting, they go to nature. The first thing they do is go to nature because they may not have those. It's not for everyone, but they may not have those skills down yet. So nature is relatively simple in terms of shapes. You want to do mountains, it's a lot of, you know, triangles and angles and stuff like that, trees. Yeah, there is no proportion or anatomy for a tree that is so complex as compared to a human's face or a human proportion that we stare at every day. I can quickly sketch out a tree and you can't tell me that, you know, the anatomy is completely wrong, right? Because the trees are so varied. And so I think that's why a lot of initial people, when they pick up painting, they go into landscapes. But if you want to do this kind of stuff, you still gotta be able to draw. So that helped me out a lot, picking up watercolors. Yeah. Figuring out shading and, you know, we talk about, or you hear me talk about once in a while, like values. How to define values in the human form and shadows, how the shadows fall over a face. I practiced that with pen and ink and pencil long before I ever tried to do that with, before I tried to do that with watercolors or painting or anything. Okay. I'll put a little orange in the blood. And then overlay it with some, just to make it look a little like it's hit by light. And I'm gonna follow that up with some deep cadmium red while it's still wet. And just let the orange and red just kind of play with each other here. See what happens. How's it going, Amy Lee? Cannibal Wolf. Shimmers C2. I hope your weekend is ending well. I'm glad you guys can join me. Let's get a bigger brush here. And I'm just going to do another wash. Just to darken up the corners. Go over where I actually, you know, this brush, it's kind of dry. So hopefully get some interesting textures on here. Drops. Liking how this is looking and feeling. I gotta start putting some bands behind it here, just so I can pull out those claws here a little bit more. Little textures and stuff really have added a lot to the bottom of this piece. What do you guys think? just gonna add some separation up here. I'm finally putting in some charcoal gray and some lamp black together. And just darkening up just to pop Wolverine out a little bit more. I can pop Wolverine out, I'm doing good. So I'm just hitting the edge of Wolverine with all this other stuff behind him, all these ninjas. And just, I'm gonna give him a little halo, so to speak. It'll be small, it'll be slight. But I think it'll make a big difference. So all the shadows are just going to be darker as they run into the edge of Wolverine. Oh. You're in recovery position. Blood. Lots and lots of blood. So much blood. I think I need to just really lose a lot of detail here and just make it darker. And I think I'll do the same thing here. I'll just do it. Same around this ninja star, because I really want this ninja star to be pulled out. Wolverine and a big pile of dead bloody ninjas. There you go. Thank you. Let's darken this a little bit more. Just trying to find areas where the light is going to hit and where the shadows are and where I want to really pull out contrast. So although I like some of these, and this is the hard part, because I like all these little textures there, for the sake of else, I think I'm going to just hide a lot of that. And it's still there, right? Because this watercolor is transparent, but all that effort that I put in there. And maybe I'll go back in and scrub away, very similar to what I did down here, and hit these cracks. Maybe I'll do a little scrubbing and pull out a few extra creases or something from the ninja's folds of the cloth and stuff like that, right? So that looks a little better now. But those are tough things for me to do. So I'm like, I put all that work in. I have to just cover it all up. Yeah, so this is a really, you see all the different layers and stuff. All the different layers that are coming in here. I'm probably gonna cut into this a little bit because it's too light all the way around. And so I'm going to cut in here and darken all this stuff. And even that little bit of white that I saved all the way since the very beginning, I just went over it. And that hurts. Because it makes me feel proud that I saved pieces of white all the way to the very end, especially on a piece like this. To my whites as long as I could. All right, so I have that, this shape, and this shape that's leading into this piece here, so I can pop out that arm. Alright, that's looking good. Thank you. So I figured out that whole Volt thing. It's either random, or where I was shown before, it was either random, or you can you guys could actually go vote for me. Which I will try to make sure that you guys do next time. But they randomly pick people, and then they have people vote on which one gets featured. And if you guys want me to get featured, as I know you do, you guys can vote for me. I'll send you the link next time. I don't think I'm going to be featured again. I was just featured, so we'll see. Okay. Yes, goodbye, little white. Alright, so this is the lovely part of the fact that I have not used black yet on this piece, because this is pretty dark over here. But now I want to push it back further, too, because I've darkened everything. And so here's where I may actually go in. And I won't use a pure black, I'll touch it up with a purple or something like that. But I will do something like this. To help create some more definition in here. Is Nye to vote to be featured on the Twitch creative page, which is kind of cool. I was featured there. They change it every half hour, so this is definitely a good example of, you know, holding back using the darkest colors you have. And even now I can still kind of hit these areas where I thought were pretty dark enough already. I can really get those details in there and make this thing look awesome. Darkened up all the things underneath him. They were too light before. I actually may cut across that real quick. And then Doc Hux, thank you for following me. So, I think I am good for today. I am starting to feel a little hungry. Getting to be time for dinner. I think Orshi is getting sleepy. I can see her falling asleep. Eyes like fluttering there. For those of you who are not following me, please feel free to follow me on Instagram and Twitter and all those things. Tony Moy, Tony underscore Moy, or Tony Moy 88. It was my pleasure to paint for you today. Everyone on here, Amy Lee, Kendall Wolf, Doc Hux, Galeen, Hoff, Isnai, John, Shimmers, Vaudience, Gibson. I actually might be able to, my next stream will definitely be next weekend. I will actually try, if you follow me, to be on Wednesday evening as well. So for the European people, that'll be pretty late in the morning, so I apologize for that. Your eyes are getting sticky too. A little sleepy over there. Well, sorry about your, sorry about the football. Looks like France couldn't buy it. Thanks, Orshi. Thank you. It won't be the same without you there if I do it. Alright. Okay. On that note, say bye-bye to Wolverine. There it is. Just a quick little watercolor thing that I put together. Alright, miss you all. Have a great weekend. Enjoy the rest of the week, and I'll see you at the very latest next week. Talk to you all soon. Thank you for joining me today. And alright, bye.